everyone. So today I'm going to do a review and demo for you. This is going to be about the new Maybelline Dream Nude Air Foam Foundation. Now I reviewed, let's see if I have it here. I don't think I do, but I reviewed the Revlon new airbrush makeup, and I saw this when I was in Target. This is in my like vlog video that I posted a few days ago. I wanted to pick this up to kind of compare them for you. They are very, very different. I've tried this on my hand, but this is going to be a little bit of a first impressions video as well because I have never put this on my face. So we'll do it together. I got shade 160, which is light beige. Now, all of these looked a little orange to me. I don't know if they look different when you put them on your skin, so we're going to find that out, but this may not be the exact right shade. I've found that picking the shade out in the drugstore, usually I can pick my shade just spot on with any drugstore makeup as long as I can see it. Because these are airbrushed and they're in a can and there are no testers, it's really hard to pick your exact match. The Revlon one worked out pretty well. It's a tiny bit dark for me, but it's not too bad. So I could still like use that in the summer and whatnot. But this one has an SPF of 16 and it's 160 light beige. So we're going to go ahead and get started. This says, has like little instructions on the back for you. Makes it really easy. It says, shake can well before use. Hold can upright and press lightly to dispense a walnut-sized amount of product. Take small dabs of product from hand. Oh, gosh. Apply to face one section at a time, blending with short circular motions. And this has it doing with fingers. I'm going to try to do this. I don't like to use my fingers to apply my foundation. I'm going to try it with a brush. Like, I used a brush to do the Revlon one. But I have tried it on my hand, and this doesn't deflate like the Revlon one. So we might really have to apply this with our hands. But let's try it with the brush first. So we'll shake it really well. All right. I'm going to take the cap off. This is what the pump looks like. I'm going to take it and press lightly. Okay, so we have it here. And that is what it looks like. Let's see. We'll try to apply this with a brush first. I'll zoom in so you guys can see a little bit better. There we go. I feel like that's probably better for you guys. So you can see, it looks a little orange when you first put it on, but it looks like it's not as bad once it's blended in. That it shows more true. I'm gonna blend it down my neck a little. And so now it has deflated on my hand, and look at that. That looks so orange. I wonder if it looks as orange on camera. It's hard for me to see. All right, now I didn't do my forehead yet, so I'm just going to take this. Probably don't need to shake it much. And just do a really small amount. This is also very hard to control. You have to push really hard. So inevitably, it's going to like spurt out at you, and you're going to kind of get... That's what I don't like about the Revlon one too. It is so hard to get a small amount. With the Revlon one, it's pretty full coverage, so you really don't need a lot. And it's like really hard to get a small amount. Okay, so I'm gonna add a little bit more. This seems to be way lighter than the Revlon. It looks like it blends pretty well. I'm thinking it feels good. It feels super, super light, like it's already drying. It feels pretty nice. I'm not sure. I'm trying to look at the color on camera, and I'm not sure if it looks super orange to you guys, or if it does blend out pretty well and it's not orange. But it just looks so incredibly orange on my hand. Look at that. It doesn't even look dark. That looks orange. Like, it doesn't even look dark there. It just looks really orange. So I'm going to put a little bit more on my cheeks. Just feel like I need a bit more coverage. This definitely feels more of a sheer coverage, whereas the Revlon is more of a full, which I like. I always look for medium to full coverage foundations. That's what I'm looking for when I look, when I'm buying foundation. I'm going to take this over my eyes. A that is the finish. You guys can see this a little bit better than I can. I'll see it more probably when I upload, but you can see it did a good job covering. I do have some scarring down here, and I can already see that I'm gonna have to cover that even more. Overall, it looks okay. My first impression, it seems like it did a decent job covering, and I don't think it comes off orange when you see it. I think maybe I would add a touch more coverage. It's a very light foundation. It feels like it dries almost instantly, which I like because it feels like it's not gonna rub off. And the Revlon one is so creamy that it kept transferring. But so far, I really like how this feels. And I think it looks okay on camera. I don't know if it's like, you know, that airbrush finish. I think that if you were gonna be taking pictures and really wanted a foundation that was gonna give you the airbrush look, I would choose Dior Airflash, but the Revlon one is good. You just don't wanna pick anything with sunscreen. And this has a sunscreen, so I feel like this is a little bit, what's the word? Like, it just doesn't really make sense to me, because when you are taking photos and you're looking for a true airbrush makeup, you want to find something that has no SPF, because when you take flash photography, the SPF is going to flash back and it's going to make you look really pale, and you do not want that. So I wouldn't take pictures, like really nice professional pictures, wearing this because it does have the SPF. Now, I'm not sure if the Revlon one has SPF. I'll put that scrolling down here so you guys can know. But yeah, overall, I think it looks okay. I really like it, that it's light. If you're looking for like a really light, moussey foundation, this is actually really nice. The color range, I know they have a bunch of different colors. Again, it's a problem, you know, with drugstore makeup, and usually you can see it in the tube, so you can see, you know about what shade you are, and you probably will be able to guess with this, but you might find that it's a bit light or a bit dark, and you might have to go back and exchange it for your right color. That's the only thing about not being able to see what the color looks like, because they put it on the can, but look at that. That is not what color it is, clearly, and that looks incredibly orange, as does my hand, but I think it looks different when it's all blended in. So, I do like this foundation. I think it's perfect for somebody looking for something with an SPF, something really light, just to really even out the skin tone. But you can see it doesn't cover my scarring here. It did cover my redness, which is nice, and it did even it out. But I definitely will still have to use some concealer, something that I didn't actually have to do with the Revlon makeup because it was so full coverage. So this is a bit lighter than Revlon, and I like that it dried more, and it's not transferring. I don't feel like it's going to transfer. And it feels really nice and not drying, almost like a satin finish. So I really like that, guys. That's it for my first impressions video. If you have any questions specifically about this or need help picking out a color, you can always message me, email me. It's all down there. Tweet me and leave a comment, and I will respond to you as many as I can. I hope you all are having a fabulous day, and I will see y'all next time. Bye.